you must borrow for purposes that are necessary. The borrowing must be responsible, Mr. Speaker. The borrowing ought not to give direct awards to your friends.
On July 12th, Prime Minister and Minister for Finance, Honorable Philip J. Pierre, tabled 5 motions in the lower house to authorize the government to access capital from various international financial institutions to advance the implementation of key economic initiatives. A U.S. $10 million loan at concessionary rates from the Export-Import Bank of the Republic of China on Taiwan, according to Honorable Pierre, will be strategically invested in St. Lucia's emerging productive sectors and also fund ongoing capital projects. The finance minister observed the local CMOS and craft sectors are ripe for expansion.
$500,000, Mr. Speaker, will be used for the expansion of the craft and CMOS subsectors. Mr. Speaker, St. Lucia has been doing very well in the production of CMOS for exports, and we want to increase the value of the product so we can add value to the raw CMOS. And with the support of Exports St. Lucia and the Ministry of Agriculture, that work is being done so that we can increase foreign exchange and increase our export of CMOS at a higher value. And Mr. Speaker, it's the craft, Mr. Speaker. The St. Lucia again has been producing some very, very, very attractive pieces of craft, particularly from Schozel, and that loan will be used to uplift the craft center and to uplift the production of craft. Again, causing the people of St. Lucia to get involved in the development of the country, paying attention to the people, the regular people, the farmers, the CMOS farmers, and the craft vendors and the craft people in Schozel, Mr. Speaker.
Part of the U.S. $10 million loan will also be allocated to the establishment of the youth economy.
Mr. Speaker, $7.2 million of that loan will be used for the youth economy program. And as you know, in the budget, we allocated $10 million for the youth economy project. And in your paper, Mr. Speaker, you will see the youth economy agency bill, which is going to be discussed, debated in this Honorable House, Mr. Speaker. So this money is actually the starting of the youth economy, which we've spoken so much about and which has garnered a lot of interest, both in St. Lucia, $7.2 million, easy.
The finance minister explained that the investments from the loan will spur job creation, provide entrepreneurs and businesses access to resources and seed funding, and ultimately stimulate economic growth in St. Lucia. From the office of the Prime Minister, Brihani Isidore.